Hi, my name is Abhishek. I have a legal intern at Lexis & Company. So today's my topic is adequate time for probe investigation in heinous offences. So before proceeding with the topic, I request you like, share my videos and subscribe to channel LexClick. So what is this issue? So taking cue from Andhra Pradesh Disha Bill 2019, Maharashtra government recently proposed Maharashtra Shakti Act of 2020. The legislation again attention given the provision of reduced period of investigation. So let us talk about what is the bill. So Disha Bill mandates completion of investigation within 7 working days for heinous offences where adequate conclusive evidence is available. These include cases such as harassment of women, sexual assault on children and rape. The Apex Court has already ruled in favor of the prosecutrix, statement alone being sufficient to convict an accused. The forensic evidence is corroborative in nature in this regard. Given this, the interpretation of adequate conclusive evidence by the police shall remain a problem. The police, in fact, are concerned primarily with collection of all evidence relating to the offence, and it is the only for the court to evaluate whether the available evidence is sufficient to convict the accused. So notably, Disha Bill has been withdrawn temporarily by the AP government following queries by the centre before it could get presidential assent. So why it is important? So though the Disha Bill is withdrawn, it is important to look into as more states may legislate to reduce the period of investigation. Taking a cue from Disha, the Maharashtra government recently announced that it would enact a law to deal with these similar cases. The proposed Maharashtra Shakti Act of 2020 will have stern punishment for offences of sexual assault and will also have a provision to complete investigation within 15 days. So let us talk about how do investigation go about. So generally, the time of investigation depends on the severity of the crime, the number of accused persons and the agencies involved, and it includes examination of the scene of the crime by investigation officer, which we call IO, and forensic expert, recording the statement of the victim by IO and the judicial magistrate and witnesses, and medical examination of the victim, female and accused person, for victim as a female at a place where a female doctor is available, and collecting documents related to age from parents, local bodies and school, and DNA finding of the forensic science lab, and the test identification parade of accused person, seizing weapons of offense, and the arrest of accused person, etc. And this is beside the fact that in many cases of rape, the victim remains under trauma for some time and is not able to narrate the incident in details. The speed and quality of investigation also depend on whether a police station has separate units of investigation and law and order. And it also depends on the number of available IOs and women of police officer, and the size and the growth of the SSL and its DNA unit. So let us talk about what is the ideal time for investigation. As per the CRPC, the investigation relating to offences punishable with imprisonment up to 10 years must be completed within 60 days of detaining the accused. For offences with higher punishment, it is to be done within 90 days. And if this fails to happen, then he or she shall be released on bail. To speed up the process, the CRPC was amended in 2018. The period of investigation was reduced from 90 to 60 days for all cases of rape. Though every investigation has to be completed without unnecessary delay, there is no investigation when the offender are at large. And each investigation is guided by its own set of facts and circumstances. And two gruesome cases of sexual assault and murder are important to mention in this regard. So first, in the Nirbhaya case, the police filed a charge sheet on the 18th day of its reporting. No effort was spared to nab the criminals and the case was rigorously supervised. However, in the recent Hathras case, the police took more than 90 days to file a charge sheet. So let us talk about what is the way forward in this. So investigation of a sensitive offense should be done expeditiously, and however, setting narrow timelines for investigation creates scope for procedural loopholes which may be exploited during trials. And therefore, instead of fixing unrealistic timelines, the police should be given additional resources so that they can deliver efficiently. So that's it.